I deem it a great pleasure to be present here with you on this important occasion in the life of our great party, the NDC. It gives me hope. And today, the hope has been affirmed that I've come to realize that there are so many young men and women who are still fighting and fighting to ensure that the great NDC retains power come November 7th this year. I want to thank you so very much for that intervention. Upon seeing the youth in their tan t-shirts and with the enthusiasm with which you have organized this occasion, it reminds me of a story. A story that says that in one particular community, when they were looking out to ordain or to select somebody as a chief of the community, they finally decided that the person to be their chief was Agama Lizard, Banduzuji Amabiola. When they selected Agama Lizard as the chief of the community, they did that when he was away. He was not home when they selected him. So upon arrival, it was announced to him that in his absence, he was selected as the chief of the community. He gathered everybody and said, "Are you very sure that you selected me as the chief of this community?" They said, "Yes, we selected you as the chief of the community." It's okay. "And did everybody agree that I am the chief of this community?" They said, "Yes." "Hey, when you were selecting me as the chief, were the youth, the children present?" They said, "No, this was a decision for adults. It was a decision for grown-ups to take. So why would they consult the young people and children?" The man said, "Look, they are very important people that if you want to do anything very successfully, you need to engage and involve them." The people still refused because they thought they were grown-ups and their opinion matter and no other person's opinion matter in that circumstance. So the following morning, the great king Agamaliza decided to take a walk around the community. When he appeared in public, before they realized, children started throwing sticks and stones at him. He runs to this corner, they throw a stone. Then he goes to this wall, they throw a stone. He runs into the house, they throw a stone. He ran back and gathered the community members and said, I told you, I cannot be the chief of this community without the approval of the young children. His Excellency John Dramani Mahama cannot be the president of this country without the approval of the youth of Ghana. And I have seen the approval of the youth here, that you have taken it upon yourself to mobilize and to garner support for His Excellency and the parliamentary candidates in the area. I want to stand here on behalf of the best gentleman of the country to show our appreciation and to tell you thank you so very much for the effort. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, In one of his hadiths, fi kulli makan makab. Every gathering has what you have to say there. So this is an educational institution, and therefore I must talk about issues of education. I want to assure the authorities of this school and the students of this school that the Gambaga College of Education is the baby of the NDC government. It is our baby. Carried the pregnancy for 9 months and we delivered the school. And we are fully aware that the school at this particular point is being breastfed. And we commit to continue to breastfeed the school until it becomes a full-blown college of education that will match the standards of any college in Ghana. As a result, whatever support the school needs, we in authority will continue to push and ensure that we provide all the necessary felt needs of this college to ensure that it stands on its feet. Just the day before yesterday, I was in Accra, and I had to go to the Ministry of Education, and I worked together with Honorable Ablakwa, and we went to present documentation to the authorities to ensure that all the teachers in the schools are absorbed completely. I did that just yesterday. You will all remember that being a new school, issues of transportation has been a challenge, and you have all seen. His Excellency did that in Accra. He presented a bus and a pickup to the school, and I in turn did that just on Saturday to the principal. I think it was the administrator. It was Abdallah that came to Tamale, and I handed over the keys of the bus and the pickup to him in order to support the school to grow. Our political opponents have started playing games with that message. And Tescom, my friend from the India, he said every school was given, every school was not given. Some selected schools were given, and this school was one of the schools that was selected to be given. But assuming without admitting that every school was given, which government gave it? Which government gave it, please? Even if every school was given, it is the NDC government that gave them, and it was His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Ghana, in the person of John Dramani Mahama, that gave out the buses. They brought them to me in Tamale, and I in turn handed them over to the various schools. So some selected schools were given, and this school was given. I want to give you some piece of information that is not known to your school authorities. And therefore, take it first-hand information. By the 29th of this month, check the daily graphic, and you would have found an advert that Get Fund is coming to renovate your assembly hall as well as the dormitories for you. I assume. So on the 29th, you can check the newspapers. Last month, or when I was 2 months ago, a team came from Accra, and I was supposed to come with them to Gambaga here. But that particular day, I had another important assignment, so I delegated my deputy regional minister to come with the team. When they came, the people of Gambaga handed over a new site to the government for us to ensure that we come to put up the best facilities for you to be relocated to that particular place as a permanent location. Despite this, we will still continue to renovate the buildings because the plan is that we want to turn it into a demonstration school so that when finally you relocate to your new school, the school will still be available for you to do your teaching practice. So His Excellency the President is committed to making sure that this school grows. And you are lucky to have a regional minister who happens to be one of you that will continuously remind His Excellency about the commitment to do that. My advice today is that the MPP told a story and you bought the story. And I'm going to caution you to jettison that story and find your own story. The idea that we do not have anything is not true. The MPP as a political party is in opposition. And they are struggling to survive. Because this is the third defeat we are about to deliver to them. And whatever effort you see them making in the area and mobilizing people, that is what the white man will refer to as the last kick of the dying horse. That's what they are doing. But the secret is that because they are in opposition, when they select their Tesco members, they themselves raise their own monies to run their affairs and not the party that gives them. But because we are in power, our team members will want to depend completely on government appointees to be able to run. So I want to advise that sometimes you need to think out of the box and put some innovative ideas in place to enable you to be able to raise your own funding in addition to whatever we will offer you as government appointees. In that case, your activities can become very sustainable. For instance, you could have printed your t-shirts. It could cost you 10 cedis to print, and an NDC diehard can buy that t-shirt by the amount of 15 cedis. In that case, you will be making some income of 5 cedis on that particular t-shirt. So you have to begin to think about some innovative process of raising income. All of you who have been suffering for the party, do not think you are doing that in vain. You are being watched, and one particular day, it is your particular effort and your support to tame that would have been the very reason why you may be supported for an appointment in government. And I want to encourage you to continue to give up your best to the great NDC party. Because I'm standing in Mamprugu, I will make a point that is going wrong. It's an erroneous impression that the NDC government has done nothing in Mamprugu. It is not true. The NDC government has not appointed Mamprugu into influential position. It is not true. I am the latest addition to numerous appointments His Excellency gave to Mamprugu. I am here as a regional minister. Honorable His Excellency, former Deputy Regional Minister, Nassau Assembly is currently the ambassador to Burkina Faso. As I speak to you now, the elder brother and the chief of the elder brother to Dr. Mahmoud Bawumia and the chief of Keringa Kena has been given letters to become ambassador to Morocco. As I speak with you now, the Deputy Minister for Environment and Natural Resources is Dr. Sugri Tia, our own MP. And then the last thing I want to talk about is that, in fact, let me continue, that the whole Metro Mass, the MD, which is normally a political appointment, is Alassane Ludi from Gambaga, who is a Mamprugu, who is the MD for Metro Mass, the whole of Ghana. Haji Board Chairman, Honorable Alhaji Ibrahim Tanko from Mamprugu Maduri, he is the Haji Board Chairman, the whole Ghana, he is the one managing it. He's one of us. So if anybody comes to tell you that this party has not given people positions, then the person is only playing political game. The Great NDC Party is our party, and we will not allow propaganda to be the basis for which we will ignore our great party. All of us must strive to ensure that come 7th of November, His Excellency John Dramani Mahama has the opportunity to rule the country. And we believe that the performance of His Excellency within the 4 years can be compared to what the MPP did in 8 years. Unprecedented infrastructure development this man has put. Last week I was in command in Accra and I was marveled that when I was trying to go to Tema and they took me to Bemakam and we use asphalt road in the bush. There are no houses there and there are roads connecting that place to Tema. His Excellency John Dramani Mahama deserves another 4 years so that he can also rule for 8 years. You who have political ambitions, do not let us carry all our eggs in one basket. We should diversify our membership from the political parties to the extent that at any point in time, if there's any political party in power, we can also find ourselves adequately represented in that particular party. Tribalism has no place in democracy. Tribalism has no place in democracy because when democracy decides to adopt tribalism as a way to go, then when war breaks up, it becomes difficult to manage. The story of Rwanda is there for everybody to see. So I would want to advise my brothers and sisters present here to imbibe politics, to join political parties, but do not make tribalism the basis for which you belong to any political party. With these few words, I want to thank you so very much for your attention. God bless you. And I understand you will be starting your examinations on Monday. What I will say is that I will pray the Almighty Allah, and I want to pray the prayer of Prophet Moses for you. Rabbi asrahli sadri wa yassirli amri wa hallil 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. May you have success in the examination. Thank you very much.